Last episode, we left off putting brand new brakes and wheels on my son's Acura. Today, I can't break the last wheel lock off, so we can't do shit. All my sockets and breaker bars are broken.
All my friends are dead.
All my tools are gone. I have to give up already. And I just got back from a long break. But I can't break the nut loose to get the wheel off to finish the brakes.
He's caught the brakes. Break it up, break it up, break it up.
What am I gonna do?
Push me to the
Doug, Doug.
Turns out I won. It's not even a problem.
Push me to the edge. Phantom, that's all red. Inside all white. Let's all day you ride a sled. I do want that head. My brilliant armor.
Amplifier is produced by Soundman Enterprises, Inc., Mobile Solutions, and CT Sounds.
Well, this one's awake. On the side?
Yeah.
Again? Is it held? Is it held down?
Yeah.
Pump again and hold. Turns out my nipples ain't bleeding because the brake bleeders are full of rust and corrosion. I called Pedro at O'Reilly's. He said he doesn't sell his nipples by themselves. I have to buy his entire caterpillar for a nipple.
I'm telling you, this is for reals.
Pedro, I don't have time for this. I don't know how we got on the subject of caterpillar nipples, but I got to bleed the brakes.
Done.
Right now is. The bleeders ain't bleeding. This one works.
All right, can I press the brake slowly?
She's a pissin'.
She's a pissin'.
Hold it down, don't let up.
I'm holding.
Careful, don't back yourself. Don't hit the mule.
Stop it.
You're just swinging it around all willy-nilly. Oh, you almost hit the deer!
Dude, there's like no headlights for my car. Like, you can't even find them, dude.
I've been reading comments again. Apparently, people have a problem with me working on the Acura in the middle of the White Rider series. One guy left a comment and said, "Haven't been here in a while. How did you shrink the T-Bird?"
What?
What an idiot! People want me to start an entire new show per vehicle. Do you have any idea how much time that would take? Russell left a comment breaking down the entire show format like his name is Roger Ebert. Russell's fat mom even left a comment. They should start their own show called Schnitzel and Knees Hurt. Because Russell's a dick and his mom's a hoe. That's why her knees hurt.
I was stunned by the picture. I was stunned that anyone would make this picture. I was stunned by the fact
that there are parts of it that are so bad.
Get this lug on this top one. This 90. Is a 99.
Oh, what the heck?
Where is it, dude? Just worry about the top one only. Yeah, there you go. And then see that? See how it flops right out of place? A lot of you liked the previous wheels that were already on the car, which are some 16-inch CCW replicas with a poked-out lip looking like Bruce Kardashian. Those wheels looked great on the car, but what you can't probably see on camera is that all four wheels are curbed. Poked-out lips, busted all out, curbed, looking more like Bruce Kardashian's back lips. You don't want them. You want nothing to do with those back lips. The goal for this car is to slap together a simple, clean, and cheap daily, so it got some 17-inch Fast and the Furious specials with a normal offset for $680. What are you gonna do? That's what it got. Which gives me an idea for a brand new show.
Rice, baby.
Doug, right now is not time for this.
Now take three lug nuggets and one wheel lock. There's one. Okay, now grab it. Hurry up.
Stop it. Make sure that one's nice and good.
Oh, what the?
Yeah.
What the?
It's gonna go. Let it go. Let it put itself on. Be one with
Dude,
the wheel.
Look at this. You're not seeing what I'm seeing.
See what?
Oh, no.
See? See how it put itself on?
What, as I touched it, it just got on there?
It was all crooked.
Because it's gonna listen. Like good wheels. Rob gave us a mismatching lug nut. What the hell, Rob? Yeah. Would you look at it? These wheels look good on this fine, low-mileage 2.3-liter luxury machine. The new brakes stop, collaborate, and listen. Ice is back with a brand new invention. Something grabs a hold of the brake rotor tightly. With these brand new tires, this car's gonna flow like a harpoon daily and nightly. We bled the brakes.
Will it ever stop?
Yo, I don't know.
Now we just need to fix this check engine light. Because if there was a problem.
Yo, I'll solve it. Check out the hook while my DJ.
Doug, right now it's not time for this.
Oh yeah, was there supposed to be one up here?
I think it's gonna use that H-shield. I think that's on the mule.
Yeah.
I picked up this car for the low price of $1,500 because the guy couldn't clear the check engine light. He said the code shows a bad O2 sensor, and he replaced the sensor, and the car still has the same problem. I called Pedro at O'Reilly's. He said it's probably the rear O2 sensor. So I gambled and pre-bought the rear O2 sensor. I'm gonna swap it, and it's gonna work, I think. What if it doesn't?
She could become the greatest fighter who ever lived.
He better be right. O2 sensor, heater circuit, bank 1 sensor. Heater circuit.
That's what he's saying, bank 1 though?
My OBD2 scan tool shows that there's a problem with the front O2 sensor's heater circuit. And I discovered a pile of butt connectors in the engine bay, so I'm betting that the front O2 sensor is just wired wrong. Pedro was wrong. I'm gonna have to take this O2 sensor I bought back to O'Reilly's and get my money back. Pedro's gonna take an O2 sensor to the bunghole, shove it up his ass. Give me my money!
So we need to know the car side O2 wire code.
Yeah, that way we can match it up.
Then we can just go on the other two. So these are the butt connectors. We're thinking maybe we have a couple of these wires just swapped since the pigtail was cut off. I just had this pulled up so I could access it. Palm of my hand hurts so bad. It might have been my wiener. Might have been last night. Or else it happened right now. I could have poked my hand. Oh, you son of a fat bitch! See? Now look, it's happening again. Tested to ground is, what did you guess, yellow?
Yeah.
And then white is hooked up to the one that measures power.
It's right.
So that should be right, right?
It's gonna work.
All right. Come on, boy. Come and film this victory.
I'm gonna be driving to school tomorrow.
Going to school tomorrow, boy.
Without a license.
Whatever it takes. Okay, we're starting the vehicular.
The check engine's different. Gone?
It's not coming back yet. It's definitely running different.
Yes.
It didn't come back though yet.
How much you want to bet it's relearning itself right now?
Probably is. I think we licked it, fellas.
Send it to Smog!
Send her down to Smog, Cletus!
To fix this problem, I started the car and tested the car side of the wiring. I found two grounds, a power, and one shielded wire, which is most likely the sensor output. The heater wires go to a coil, which heats the sensor, so those wires need power and ground. Then the last ground would go to the O2 sensor input. Then we have our output wire. Piece of cake. Fixed it. I did it again.
It doesn't matter what you did, Doug.
Oh, now it went up to 0.68. Bank 2 is at 0.075. It's moving around.
Mm-hmm.
So we're getting a reading from the sensor.
It worked. Son of a bitch.
The check engine light is clear. The car runs so much better. With new tires and brakes, it feels like a brand new car. I built a brand new car in 2 days. Now I can drive the Acura around while I put the new exhaust system on the F-150. Then all the parts I have will officially be installed on all of the cars that I own. Then I'll be ready to spend some more money on the T-Bird. Which I don't have because I'm broke. Which brings me to why I have this brand new shirt on my shoulder. Wait till you see this.
Look at this.
Look at this.
Somebody come look at this. Somebody come and look at this.
We're different universes here. We can't talk what? About it. Can't talk about it. It's not funny. I didn't laugh
we
once.
This is the newly revised Soundman Shop Tee, which features a small logo over the left chesticle and a large logo on the back. This replaces the old Soundman Tee, which just had a large logo on the front, and this is the upgraded new shirt. high quality fabric. I highly suggest you buy one or five or nine. Hell, buy 10.
I left throughout the picture.
Okay.
I left throughout the picture.
Well, I'm happy for you.
No. But, well, at least it's a start. It's a smile. Roger.
Shit, buy 70.
We could take this back, trade it for a battery. Is it good?
It's very good.
Is the check in the engine light stay off?
Yeah.
Yeah? Hell yeah. Very good.
Excuse me, my mouth is a little close to the microphone. I gotta open it.
Oh my goodness. Brad from CarAudioLegends.com keeps sending me free Macintosh gear. I highly suggest you go over to CarAudioLegends.com and buy something, even if you don't need it. After you buy one of the new shirts. His name is Brad Newsome. His name should be Brand. Because he keeps sending me Brand Newsome. These speakers haven't even been opened yet. Another set of 6.5s. Shit! This is Brad Newsome from Legends of Car Audio says, "Now you now have all the Macintosh I own." That's it?
What?
Oh, but I wasn't done yet. Oh, amp has broken glass, works great. Hell yeah, dude. Ooh, this one's a little one. Hell yeah. And he sent me a Macintosh amplifier with a crack in it because he knows I like crack on my glass. It's a small glass. Oh, that's so cool looking. Damn, these are nice. That still looks way better than any amp now. Any JL or fucking other piece of Chinese shit. Oh, look at this side. Wow! See, the thing that makes these amplifiers so special is that they were hand-built in America.
Boy.
With American copper. This ain't no Chinese copper. This ain't no Chinese capacitors that are gonna blow up because they're pieces of shit. Can I help you? This is the kind of amp Donald Trump uses. The capacitor internals are made from bald eagle eyelids. Very rare. Okay. See? Look at that. This has a 15 amp fuse, stereo or mono, bridgeable. Separate gains. That's a bummer that this is broken because these are so dope. This is real glass. The gold is like metallic gold. This is sweet. Thanks, Brad. Go check out legendsofcaraudio.com. He has a wonderful selection of awesome old school gear, such as this beaut. Son of a fat bitch.
Oh my gosh, just look at it.
Look at it.
Look
at it. These components have passive networks. So you could run this two channel on these components.
Alleluia.
The T-Bird already has an iPad kit, so I might use this two channel and a set of the Macintosh components to set up a nice front stage for the T-Bird. The Acura is done for now. I have a deck we could throw in the dash so there's not an empty hole. We can get the stereo working, but we'll do that later. Next, I have to put the exhaust system I got for the F-150 on the F-150. Then we can go back to the T-Bird and either replace those check valves and start the battery rack, or if I don't have the money in the budget to start that yet, we could do the stereo system. Don't let that sway your purchasing decision on the t-shirts. I don't want you to not buy a shirt because you want to see me put the stereo in. Either way, you should buy a shirt.
Send me your collections because I ain't paying, dude.
All I'm saying is it's a nice shirt. Fucking nice. Thank you guys so much for your support. Head over to the website, grab the new shirt. The Explosion t-shirts were limited, those are now gone. The regular Soundman t-shirt, Amplified t-shirt, and hats will always be up there, and they are now shipping. Thank you guys again for your support. Come back every Monday and Thursday at 7 a.m. You guys have a great weekend. Support Amplified by purchasing iPad dash kits and Soundman merch from soundmanca.com. Take your fabrication skills to the next level with the tools and trainings available from mobilesolutions-usa.com. Check upcoming training dates at mobilesolutions-usa.com/training. Go to ctsounds.com to get a discount on quality car stereo equipment with coupon code SOUNDMAN. See what kind of stereo system you could put together for your budget at ctsounds.com.